In this video, you're going to learn how to segment your products in your Google Shopping campaign. If you haven't created your Google Shopping campaign yet, you need to do that first. You also need to create your Google Merchant Center account and your product feed. I have videos showing you how to do every single thing to get up to this point here. I'll leave them down below, so check the description. Why segment our products? Segmenting our products into ad groups and product groups improves our targeting and helps with optimizations later on. Let's go into our Google Shopping campaign and find the ad group that we created. Here under product groups, we see the product group that we created. It contains everything in your feed. We want to subdivide this product group, so we'll mouse over the name of it and Google displays a plus sign. Clicking it brings us here where we can sort through the products based on select information Google has from our feed. Brand will show us all the brands we have entered into the brand fields, for example. Item IDs show us every product because every product must have a unique item ID. Google also shows you the title right after the item ID, which is helpful if you want to use this search function here to find certain products. Condition simply divides products based on how they're new, used, or refurbished. You may remember that product type is an optional field that Google gives us to create our own categories. Here's where that pays off because you can now use that to easily subdivide between your categories here. If it's your first campaign, this is not entirely necessary. That's more for advanced users. Channel is for differentiating between local imagery and online. Channel exclusivity segments products by availability in one of the channels or both. We're not covering local ads in this video or in our free shopping course, but I'll include some links down below if you'd like to explore that more. And finally, we have custom labels. These are, of course, something that you can set up in your product feed, and they're a fantastic way to further sort and segment your products. For example, if you're selling t-shirts and you know that certain colors are more in demand than others, you can have a custom label for colors. By subdividing the more popular colors out to their own product groups, you can make sure that they get higher bids. As another example, say you've labeled in your feed which products are high margin and which are low margin. You may want to segment out the low margin products so that you can bid lower on them than the rest of the products. There are a million ways to use these custom labels for smart product segmentation, and you'll need to think of the right way to do it for your products. If you recall, we created this ad group to target wallets. For this campaign here, because we're doing manual bidding on the product level, we're going to select by item ID, select all of the products by clicking this box here, scroll down to make sure that all the products have been selected, and then click continue to edit bids. It's now going to show this page here. If you're just setting up your campaign, I recommend keeping the bids at the same level unless there are huge differences between your products. For example, you're selling a product for $5 and also a product for $500. You don't want to bid the same and you should adjust your bids right now. Once confirmed, click save. We now see that we have our product groups split out for each of our products. If we want, we can now edit the bids individually for each product based on performance. We have a full video showing our complete strategy, including the template we use to actually manage these bids once we get some clicks and some conversions. That is a key part of optimizing and scaling your campaigns to at least 50 to 100 conversions per month. I'll leave a link down below. It's definitely recommended watching for everyone watching this video. Segmenting your products starts at the campaign level, then to the ad group level, then to the product group level, and then to product groups within product groups. There's a reason that Google gives you the ability to set up the structure like this. And that's because you know your catalog better than anybody. You can choose to segment your products according to category, best sellers, profit margins, attributes like color and size, price points, and even down to the individual product level. This organization helps you immensely as you review the data and start making optimizations. Now that we've taken the time to create the structure, take the time to outline how you're going to conduct your product segmentation. Map it out on a piece of paper or in a document. This planning will pay off for you in months to come. So, do you feel like you're ready to go live with your campaign? In the next video, we're going to go through our pre-launch checklist and get everything ready to launch. If you're watching this video on YouTube, this is actually part of our free Google Shopping course on our website. It shows you how to set up, optimize, and scale your campaigns 100% free with no sign-up required. I'll leave a link down below. Click the link to keep going through the next lesson. If this video was helpful, please hit the like button and let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.